Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about alternation of generation in different groups of plants. Different groups of plants show three types of alternation of generation. That is, members in their life cycle shows sporophyte phase and gametophyte phase. Sporophyte phase and gametophyte. In the case of bryophytes, we studied the dominant phase is gametophyte. Whereas in the case of pteridophytes, we studied the dominant phase is sporophyte. So, sporophyte gives gametophyte, gametophyte gives sporophyte in their life cycle. Plant bodies, and that is plants, show alternation of generation. In the life cycle, they show two stages. So, in detail, we studied about first cycle, haplontic cycle. Recall in short, haplontic cycle. Haplontic. What is that? In the entire cycle, starting from here up to here, this much space, like this. This much space, in the this much part is haploid. Is haploid. Major part. Very small part is a diploid. That's why the name haplontic. Major part is haploid. Very small part is diploid. Seen in few algae. Seen in the case of few algae. Wallworts, Pyrogyra, Chlamydomonas. All these we studied in the case of algae. Algae. In these members, this type of life cycle is seen. So, algae, the gametophyte is a dominant phase. Here, go for the sporophyte. Sporophyte is represented by zygote, 2N. Sporophyte is represented by zygote, very one-celled, or in few cases, few-celled. Most of them it is one cell, and it is not free living. It is dependent upon the gametophyte. Now coming to the gametophyte. Gametophyte is this one. Now concentrate on gametophyte. Gamete producing one. By the process of gametogenesis, produce gametes. Gametophyte. Why the name gametophyte? Have the capacity to produce gametes. This, by the process of gametogenesis, generation of gametes, produce gametes. Such two gametes fuse. What is that? Fusion of gamete is syngamy. Gametes fuse. Syn, fusion. Fusion of gamete. Soon after the fusion of gamete, gametes are, what are gametes? Gametes are haploid. Gametes are haploid. These two gametes fuse, resulting in a structure which is diploid. The process is syngamy, fusion of gametes. Results in a 2N structure, zygote. This is one cell and is not free living. It is dependent upon the gametophyte. That zygote soon undergo meiosis. Produce spores. The spores are haploid. Those are haploid. These spores, on falling on a suitable substratum, germinate and give rise to gametophyte, which is the dominant phase. Which is the free living independent phase is the gametophyte. So, in the case of algae, major part in the life cycle is haploid. Major part in the life cycle is haploid. So, it is called haplontic life cycle. Small part, one cell, in few cases few cell, depend upon the gametophyte, not free living one. Not free living. Which one? Sporophyte. So, what is sporophyte? Sporophyte is this. That is, the 2N condition is called sporophyte. Here, sporophyte is represented by one-celled zygote. Yes, this one-celled zygote, which is 2N, that itself is the sporophyte, which undergo meiosis, gives haploid spores. Meiosis gives haploid spores. These spores, on falling on the suitable substratum, give rise to gametophyte. Haploid. Why? The spores are haploid. Haploid spores on germination give rise to the gametophyte. This gametophyte then produces the gametes in their sex organs. Sex organs. Those gametes after generation fuse. Both the gametes are male and female gamete. are haploid. Fusion is syngamy, results in zygote. Is haplontic life cycle seen in all this that we studied? Now the second type is exactly opposite to this. Opposite in the sense, major part is diploid, very small part is haploid. This is called haplontic. Another one is called this one, diplontic. In this diplontic, see here, starting from here, like this, here, continuation. This much part, this part, excluding this, this much entire part is diploid. This entire part is diploid. So major is diploid. So the name diplontic. Very small is haploid. So the name diplontic. Here may earlier the major one is haploid, so haplontic. Major one is diploid, so the name diplontic. Seen in all seed bearing plants, angiosperms, gymnosperms, like that. So this second category seen in seed bearing plants like gymnosperms, angiosperms. We studied these are naked seeded, these are plants which are higher plants with the, which possess seeds, which bears seeds. So all seed bearing plants possess this. So in seed bearing plants, recall in the case of gymnosperm, the plant body, what we see in nature is what? Is sporophyte. Sporophyte. So sporophyte is diploid. It itself is green. So photosynthetic, independent, and it itself is the dominant phase. It itself is the dominant phase. In the case of gymnosperms, in the case of angiosperms, a flower bearing plant is the sporophyte. In the case of life cycle of angiosperms, we studied. So the sporophyte here is diploid. The sporophyte is diploid, dominant, photosynthetic, and independent. Photosynthetic means independent, non-dependent upon the gametophyte. Such a sporophyte, gymnosperms, bears the sex organs. We studied microsporangium, megasporangium, microsporophyll, megasporophyll, and those produces the gametes. Megasporangium, microsporangium internally produce the pollen grains, the microspores, which are the female gametophyte, which later produce the male gametes, like that. Embryo sac, female gametophyte, which internally bears the embryo sac internally bears, not ovule, egg, which is the female gamete, like that. By the process of gametogenesis, it produces gametes. So this, by the process of meiosis, produce the gametes. So gametes produced are haploid. This is very small phase, only the gamete phase, haploid phase, single to few celled. In few cases single celled, in few cases few celled. This is the haploid phase. This is the haploid phase. This major part is the diploid phase. Very small, this is the haploid phase, single to few celled. See here, such two gametes, male and female gametes, fusion is syngamy. Soon after fusion, haploid plus haploid, a diploid condition is produced. So the syngamy, fusion of gametes, results in a structure known as zygote. This zygote grows and become the sporophyte. So major part in the life cycle is diploid. Major part in the life cycle is diploid. Very small part is haploid, which is the haploid phase, represented by only the gametes, single to few celled. So the name diplontic, exactly opposite to that. Haplontic, major part is haploid in algae. Diplontic, major part is diploid, seen in seed bearing plants like gymnosperms and angiosperms. Very small phase is haploid phase, single to few celled, whereas the dominant phase is diploid, sporophyte, photosynthetic, and independent, seen in these two members. Now compare haplontic and diplontic. Haplontic, diplontic. The third life cycle is haplodiplontic. Haplodiplontic. See here, this much part is diploid. This much part is haploid. So somewhat equal, 50-50%, like that, 50%. Haplodiplontic, first one haploid dominant, second one diploid dominant. Here diploid, haploid phase. This much portion is haploid, this much portion is diploid. Haplodiplontic, haplodiplontic. Seen in bryophytes as well as pteridophytes. Haplodiplontic, seen in bryophytes and pteridophytes. First we'll concentrate on bryophytes. So in the case of bryophytes, I told bryophyte dominant phase in the life cycle is gametophyte. Gametophyte later produce gametes, gametes fusion, zygote, zygote grows and becomes sporophyte. So start with the, in the case of bryophytes, gametophyte. So what is gametophyte? Gametophyte is dominant. In the case of bryophytes, gametophyte is dominant. The Marchantia, what we see, Funaria, Sphagnum, in nature what we see, the plant body, thalloid or leafy branch, actually the dominant gametophyte. So dominant, photosynthetic and independent. So in the case of bryophytes, dominant plant body is gametophyte. So in the case of bryophytes, gametophyte is dominant, photosynthetic and independent. Go here, this is the gametophyte. Gametophyte, by the process of gametogenesis, generation of gamete, generates gametes. Such gametes fuse is syngamy. Now what are gametes? Gametes produced are also haploid. All these gametes produced are haploid. Such two haploid gametes fuse, fusion is syngamy, results in a structure which is zygote, which is diploid. Results in a structure known as zygote, which is diploid. This zygote undergo mitosis and produce sporophyte. Sporophyte. In the sporophyte, I told there are three parts, food seed and capsule. In the capsule part, again undergoes meiosis, results in spores which are haploid. So first revision meiosis, second one. So now up to here it is diploid only, next it is haploid. Second meiotic division results in haploid spores. These haploid spores on falling on a suitable substratum germinate and give rise to gametophyte. Both the stages, gametophyte and sporophyte, both here are multicellular. Both here are multicellular. So third group of cycle is haplodiplontic. Haplontic, diplontic phase, somewhat equal percentage in the life cycle. Haplodiplontic phase seen in bryophytes as well as seen in pteridophytes. In the case of bryophytes, the dominant phase is the gametophyte. Plant body is the gametophyte. Gametophyte is the dominant phase which produces the gametes, that is haploid phase. Gametes on fusion diploid, zygote gives sporophyte. This sporophyte undergo meiosis to produce haploid spores. These haploid spores on germination gives haploid gametophyte, and gametophyte is dominant in the case of bryophytes. Gametophyte is dominant in the case of bryophyte, and both the sporophyte and the gametophyte are multicellular, whereas in that case I explain few as one or few cell, like that, whereas here both are multicellular. Exact opposite condition we studied in the case of pteridophytes. Plant body we studied as sporophyte. Plant body studied as sporophyte, that is in the case of pteridophyte. So in the case of pteridophyte, the sporophyte is the dominant photosynthetic independent vascular plant. vascular plant, that is pteridophytes from which vasculature developed. So somewhat similar to this, in the case of pteridophytes, it's not gametophyte, it is sporophyte. So the plant body, what dominant, photosynthetic, free living, everything in the case of pteridophyte is not gametophyte, it is sporophyte. Concentrate on sporophyte. It is dominant. Yes, a fern plant, when we see outside, it is sporophyte. Fern on its leaflets bears these spores. Fern on its leaflets bears these spores. So sporophyte. It itself is green, photosynthetic, green as well as photosynthetic, and it itself is independent. Independent phase is green, photosynthetic, independent phase is the dominant phase, that itself is vascular plant. Now go for this. Now this is the plant body in the case of pteridophytes, undergo meiosis and produces spores. These spores on falling on a suitable substratum germinate and give rise to the gametophyte. Sporophyte meiosis spores. So the spores produced are haploid. So the gametophyte is also haploid. The gametophyte is haploid. The gametophyte is haploid. It is multicellular. We studied the terms like a prothallus, somewhat heart shaped. It is prothallus. It is multicellular. Autotrophic. Multicellular. Autotrophic. In few cases, saprophytic conditions are also seen. The gametophyte here also is autotrophic. Autotrophic, independent. That is the speciality of this. Gametophyte is autotrophic. Okay, both the stages are multicellular. Now concentrate on the gametophyte. Again, this gametophyte produces gametes. Gametes on fusion results in sporophyte. So in the case of pteridophytes, sporophyte produce spores. Spores on germination give rise to the gametophyte. Gametophyte produce gametes, which on syngamy produces the zygote, like this. The speciality is even the gametophyte is also autotrophic here. Gametophyte is also autotrophic, like that. Okay, in this part is remaining. I explained this, right? Go for this in the case of bryophytes. The sporophyte so produced, where is the sporophyte produced? Sporophyte, gametophyte produces zygote, zygote later sporophyte. The sporophyte so produced is short lived, total or partially dependent upon the gametophyte. Whereas here the gametophyte is autotrophic, here the sporophyte is partially dependent upon the gametophyte for nutrition, for anchorage, like that. So the sporophyte of bryophytes, the gametophyte of bryophytes, the sporophyte of pteridophytes, and the gametophyte of pteridophytes. Pteridophyte, dominant is sporophyte, and next is gametophyte. Here the dominant is gametophyte. Dominant is gametophyte. Okay, now compare the three cycles. First one is haplontic, second one is diplontic, and third one is haplodiplontic. Haplodiplontic seen in bryophytes as well as pteridophytes. This is in bryophytes as well as in pteridophytes. This type is common in bryophytes as well as pteridophytes. Now, first one, haplontic, we studied in the case of algae. What is that? Spirogyra, Wallvox, Chlamydomonas, in there. Few exceptions are. In algae, usually we say haplontic life cycle. There are few exceptions. This is the one, second one we studied, in which case seed bearing plants, gymnosperms, angiosperms, show diplontic life cycle. This is one. Even diplontic life cycle are also seen in algae. Algae named Fucus shows diplontic life cycle. Algae named Fucus. Similarly, third life cycle is haplodiplontic. What is that? Haplodiplontic, seen in some of the algae also. Haplodiplontic seen in bryophytes as well as pteridophytes. In addition to that, some of the algae also show haplodiplontic. Few are Ectocarpus polysiphonia. Ectocarpus and polysiphonia. Now, in the case of algae, Spirogyra, Volvox, Chlamydomonas shows haplontic life cycle. Fucus shows diplontic life cycle. Ectocarpus polysiphonia shows haplodiplontic life cycle. Recall in short again, alternation of generation. So we started with haplontic life cycle. Haplontic, major phase is haploid. Observe the major phase is haploid. Haplontic, haploid phase is gametophytic phase, which produce gametes. Fusion of gametes is diploid. Diploid phase is one cell, not free living, dependent upon the gametophyte. This zygote, by the process of meiosis, produce spores. Spores on germination give rise to the gametophyte seen in these algae. Second is diplontic, seen in seed bearing plants, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Major part is sporophyte, very small part is represented by single celled haploid phase. This is the gametophyte phase. This is sporophyte, then this is the gametophyte phase, like that. That is second category. Now concentrate on the third category, haplodiplontic phase. Haplodiplontic phase is like this. Here is what? Seen in bryophytes, pteridophytes. In the case of bryophytes, dominant phase is gametophyte, which is photosynthetic independent. This gametophyte later produces the sporophyte. So this gametophyte later produces the sporophyte, which is short-lived. Sporophyte is short-lived. Capsule, the sporophyte breaks and the spores come out. Short-lived, total or partially dependent upon the gametophyte. In few cases, totally dependent upon the gametophyte. In others, it is partially dependent upon the gametophyte for fixation. That is, gametophyte bears sex organ archegonium. Archegonium inside is with egg. That egg changes into zygote. Zygote grows and becomes sporophyte. Means the sporophyte, the food part, food and food seed and capsule. The food part is deep inside the archegonium. So for dependent upon anchorage, attachment, fixation, as well as for absorption of nutrition. Like this, both the stages are multicellular. Now in the case of sporophyte, in the case of pteridophyte, dominant is sporophytic phase. Sporophytic, dominant green photosynthetic, this one. It produces spores fall on a suitable substratum, germinate and give rise to the gametophyte. In this case it is multicellular, but it is autotrophic. In most of the case, few saprophytic condition is also seen. Independent, short-lived. Soon these gametes fuse, thus resulting in sporophyte. Both the stages are multicellular. Exceptions few are: first cycle, haplontic life cycle seen in algae. Haplontic, Spirogyra, Volvox and Chlamydomonas. Whereas diplontic life cycles seen in seed-bearing plants, angiosperms and gymnosperms. In addition to that, diplontic life cycle is also seen in fucus, alga fucus. Haplodiplontic, seen in bryophytes as well as seen in pteridophytes, is also seen in two algae, Ectocarpus and Polysiphonia. Observe the cycles. Cycle representation is there in detail in the textbook. Refer those. Try to write the cycle properly. And in that case, in each case, you have to give 2 to 3 correct sentence. Why the name haplontic? Which one is the major phase? Which one is dominant phase, photosynthetic? Which one is the dependent phase? Like that. Then correct 2 to 3 examples. So each case, so try to write the 3 cycles, take your textbook, write 2 or 3 times, compare and try to write the notes for this also. Haplontic, diplontic and haplo, compare and study. So that is the end of plant kingdom. So we completed plant kingdom. Next, the continuation part. So that is unit 1 we completed. Unit 1, from the next class onwards we are starting unit 2. Yes, unit 2, lesson 5th. So we completed 4th lesson. Up to 4th lesson. Yes, thank you.